Hello, welcome to SS Unitech, Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about logins part 2. So in our last video we have discussed basics about logins and we have discussed two log providers. So if you haven't watched last video of this video series, so I would strongly recommend to watch that video before going forward. So let's start with SSIS log provider for SQL profiler. The SQL Server Profiler Log Provider, which writes traces that you can view using SQL Server Profiler. The default file name extension of this provider would be .trc. So go to on SSDT, and this is our example as we have discussed in our last video. So I am going to use that one. Go to on Logging. Here I would like to add one more. This is for SQL Server Profiler. And here I need to configure, then I need to add a file. So we can click on new, then create file, we can browse, and here I would like to use SQL profiler dot trc. I can click on open, then OK. Go to on details. So I would like to use on error and go to on advanced. It will capture the machine name, operator name, source name, text message and data bytes. Now click on OK. Now save this package and execute. So once our package will be executed, package will be failed because in our execute SQL task we have specified 1 divided by 0. That is not possible. So cancel this and go to on folder, and this is our trace file. So I would like to open this, and it will be opened in SQL Server Profiler. So this is our SQL Server Profiler, and here as we can see, this is our event class. So this is our operator name, and this is our source name, that is fine, and this is our text data. So in our text data, as we can see, executing the query select 1 divided by 0 failed with the following error: divide by 0 error encountered. So this is our error, so we can cancel. So this is for SQL Server Profiler. Next log provider would be Windows Event Log. So go to on SSDT, and here go to on Logging, and I would like to use Windows Event Log. Now we can click on add and we can select. So here in configuration we are not having anything. Go to on details. So we want to capture all the information which we have captured in our last log provider. So I can click on OK. Now we can save this and execute our package. So package should be failed, that is fine. Stop this package. Now we need to check the Windows event log. So here we need to go to on event viewer. So inside this event viewer, go to on Windows log, then application. It would take few seconds. So here as you can see error. So in this error, select 1 divided by 0 failed with the following error: divide by 0 error encountered. So this is our error which has been captured in Windows log event. And our next and last provider would be XML file. So SSIS log provider for the XML file. So it will write log entries to the XML files. The default file name extension of this provider would be .xml. So go to on SSDT, then go to on Login. In this Login, I would like to add for XML files as well. So this is for XML. So here again we need to go to on configuration, then create a new connection, and we want to generate a file. So create file, then we can browse, and here I want to capture log data dot XML. Now we can click on open, that is fine. Go to on detail. So we want to capture all the informations which we have captured in our last log provider. So click on OK. Now we can save it and click on start. So package should be failed, that is fine. Stop this package and go to on folder. So here as we can see, this is our XML. So we can open in Notepad. So it has XML data, and we can see over here, and we will try to read the error message. So this is our error message. Select 1/0 failed with the following error, 1/0 error encountered. So that is fine. So these are the log providers available in SSIS where we can store our log messages. So here we cannot use SQL Server profile log provider in package that is running in 64-bit mode. So we need to remember this. Next, as we have seen, the SQL Server log provider uses the OLADB connection manager. Others like text file, SQL Server profiler, XML file log providers uses file connection managers. The Windows event log provider doesn't use any connection manager because it writes directly to the Windows event log. So I hope you have understand how we can use logging in our SSIS package and how we can store the logs in our different formats which is available in SSIS. As we have discussed, there is 5 formats. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.